Hello guys, WeTalkAV here, and in this tutorial we will be showing you how to improve your aerial images just in few simple steps in Lightroom. So as an example, we took this image on X5S camera and 15mm standard lens. So before we start with improvements, we will have to know what parts of this image have to be improved. So let me point out four reasons why we need to work on it in the Lightroom. Reason number one is this spot here, which is overexposed. It's not a good looking, it's unsharp, and overall it's just not how it's supposed to be. The second reason why we want to be recovering this image, why we want to be improving this image, is the amount of the haze over the mountains here, because some kind of stuff was smoking in there, as you can see here. And also on long distances you tend to get unclear images, which is normal, but we have to fix it anyways. The third problem with this image is shadow. Shadows in here or in here are pretty dark, I would say even too dark, and we're losing a lot of details in there. So we're gonna be recovering all those shadows in order to get more details and improve our overall look of the image. And last but not least, we want to improve the color, because colors straight out of the camera, they are not beautiful at all, they're just basic. So let's just start with that. And first step I want to do is pull the highlights a little bit down like that, so this spot is now fixed and it's pretty clear, it's pretty sharp and good looking spot. And also we didn't lose a lot of details in shadows or highlights anywhere else, so why don't we just pull this all the way down here. So the sky is looking good now. So the second thing that I will be fixing is the shadows over here, and for that reason I will be pulling shadows slider to the right somewhere about 50%. So now we're getting a lot more details, some shades from the branches and sun rays that are going through the branches, some pieces of light, and now it looks beautiful. The next thing is clarity, and we're gonna be putting this up a little bit in order to get rid of this haze over here. We will not be able to completely get rid of it, but just an improvement, just a slight improvement in that area will be visible and noticeable. Okay, you can see it's getting better now, but of course you don't want to be too hard on the clarity, you don't want to go all the way to 100%, so it will make your image look unreal and overdone, over photoshopped. So you don't want this kind of look, so I would like to keep it somewhere over 50%. 46 is all right. To improve the colors of our image, we will have to pull the vibrance and saturation up a little bit by about 10 to 15 points. You don't want to overkill it and make it look like that, which is just awful. So just pull it up a little bit, and also pull up the separate colors like yellow and orange to get this kind of look. I found it pretty beautiful. So the next step we want to do is to increase the sharpness, because sharpness is very important for landscapes. So let me increase it by 85 points. And now you can see that the sharpening here looks a little bit too harsh. So that is why I want to add a little bit more masking. And I don't think that noise reduction is necessary in this situation, because as you can see, it's ISO 100 and it's sunny day, so there is no much noise in this image. Moving on. So basically that is it, and those are the results you're gonna get in 5 minutes. Very simple, very effective, and you can apply the same techniques to your aerial shots. Just remember, never overkill it, never over Photoshop it, and your images will be looking great. Let's compare the results now. So we got from this kind of look to this kind of look, and I think it's pretty noticeable improvements. Anyway, guys, thank you for watching. Like this video if you find it helpful, share it with your friends, and make sure you subscribe for the next episode of We Talk UAV. Bye.